The principle of a 8-point grid system is that it uses a multiple of 8. So if you think 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 48, and so on, using this for layouts, dimensions, padding, margins, and elements. If you're new to product design and wondering how you space out all of your layouts, then this is the video for you. Why? Because consistent and scalable spacing helps both designers and developers work more faster and consistent on projects. In this video, I'm going to show you the benefits of using an 8-point grid system and also show you how you set one up using Figma. If you're new here, hi, what's up? I'm Gemma and I'm a senior product designer who share tips about UX for free. If that's something you're interested in, then why not hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. At this point, you may be even wondering, why do I need to design to a grid? To be fair, grids are not a new concept throughout design. Grids have been used in the past by painters, illustrators, printmakers, even within the real world when you think of cities. Everything is usually designed to a grid. Designing to a grid will allow your work to be easily integrated and consistent when it gets into development. This will significantly decrease the chances of developers coming back to you and telling you that your designs just cannot be built. It also allows for clear language against designer and developer. So why a multiple of 8? Utilizing a number like 8 to size and space elements allows for scaling with a wider variety of devices, but it allows it to be easy and consistent. Today we live in a world where there are multiple devices with multiple screen sizes, and it just isn't feasible for us to design for every single screen size. So instead we utilize a 8-point grid system, and again this allows for consistency and scalability. I'm going to keep saying these words because that's the point of an 8-point grid system. So how do you set up an 8-point grid system? This is a lot easier than you may think. If you know your 8 times table, even better. If you don't, that's okay. Just Google your 8 times table and it'll give you all the sizes you need. All you really need to think about is every time you want to space something, you keep doing it in multiples of 8. Your smaller size would be 8. And then to go up an X size, it'd be 16, and so on and so on. You can also go down as small as 4, and that's because 4 goes into 8, so it's an easy number. And this is used sparingly for little things like if you needed to space out an icon between some label, you know, things like that, where 8 seems a bit too big and 4 just seems just about right. So let's jump into Figma and I'll show you how easy this is to set up. So first of all, let's take a little look at our 8 times table. Now all you really need is these numbers going down the right hand side. So 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 48, 56, 64, 72, 80, 88, 96, and so on. Yes, these numbers can get a lot bigger than this. All you really need to do is keep adding 8. Now if I go over it a little bit, you will start to see how this now becomes into a system that we can use. So again, we start off with as small as 8, 16, 24, 32, all the way up your 8 times table. Then you can get even bigger to 96, 104, and 112. Now these sizes are used to keep spacing between, let's say, sections on a website. And these on the lower scale are to use between elements or padding or margin. If you don't know what those words are, I highly recommend you Google it, because these are things developers are going to be saying to you. But roughly the main principle is padding is contained within an element and margin is around the edges. So how do you put this into practice? So this is a 8-point grid system, or pixels, depending whichever one you want to use, but everything is in a multiple of 8. This is within a 12-column layout. Now, I want this to stretch across my whole artboard, 96 pixels of margin, and I also want 24 pixels of padding. What does this mean? So, if we look here, 96 falls into 8, and so does 24. Meaning on this layout here, from the edge of the page should be 96, on both sides 96, and in between should be 24. There you go. So the margin is on the edge and then the gutters are in between. You can also add rows in as well. So rows are everything going down, meaning at each row is at 8 pixels. So if I do this, yeah, everything is 8. If I do 2 rows, it should be 16, 3 rows, 24, 4 rows, 32, and so on. So if you want to do rows again, that's really, really useful. It helps when you don't want to add 8 together, so I highly recommend using rows whenever you need them. A set as a height of 8, and then it's repeated all the way across the frame. So how does this look in practice? So if we go over here, this is a basic wireframe. Now this is something I set up a while ago when I redesigned my first website. I will be honest with you, nothing on this layout is a multiple of 8 because I was trying to throw down my ideas as quickly as possible. You can see on the right hand side here, it has changed a lot. Everything in here is named. I always name all my layers, and if you don't name your layers, you really should name your layers, because this actually helps when you hand over to developers. That's a whole new video. I'll go into more detail in that again. But when you're doing designs, name your layers. We can see that this all lines up and everything looks relatively clean. It has really nice white space going on. It's all following a consistent pattern across everything. So straight away, visually, it looks neat. But it does also follow everything to do with 8. Even the typography is following multiples of 8. So this is at 40 and the line height is at 56. Same here, 24, 32, all following the multiples of 8. The space in between everything is also following a multiple of 8, so that's 32, 32. So this is contained and everything is following a multiple of 8. Same here, 16 pixels between them, following a multiple of 8. So even when I click into this, you can start to see again it still follows a multiple of 8. The only bit you don't see at the bottom is the extra bit of padding, and that's mainly because I wanted this little wobbly line to be there instead. So that's just in the way. But everything else is following this spacing. It's the same here when you click into this. This again is 32 and 40, 24 and 32. Everything is consistent. There's a 48 now at the top, 98 across the sides. Again, or everything is following this consistency. Same here, if you click in between them, there should be 24. Of course it is. Between these, it should be 16, 16. And these will be exactly the same. So it's always, always consistent. Between these, 48, again, another multiple of 8. Can you see now this pattern, how this pattern is always increasing? From the sides, 98, that's where I needed to be. So everything is now fitting into this system. And then we show the same here. Click into this, 32, 40, 24, 32. Everything is consistent. It has 32, falls into a multiple of 8. At the top here, 48, which is consistent, 98 across the sides, and again here it should be 48 across the bottom. Now everything is set up in auto layout. If you don't know how to do auto layout, I do have a video on my channel about auto layout, and I'll leave it in the card above. I still don't know which side this is in. Go check that out, and there's a link in the description below which will show you more about auto layout. I will be doing more videos about auto layout because, to be honest with you, if you're not using it, then you're seriously missing out on something. The reason why I use it is because it allows me to change certain way without me having to play about and pull frames around and stuff like that. So as for instance, if I wanted to change that to 98, I can. It pushes everything down. Easy. And again, the same for down here. Everything is keeping in with the consistency. It's 32, 40. The text in here will be 16 by 24. And then all the spacing around is 58. Everything works within a multiple of 8. And everything looks consistent throughout it all. And it just allows for that consistent language between designers and developers. So nobody is guessing of how much padding or how much margin or how much spacing something needs to be. An 8-point system allows you to set that up way in advance, meaning every time you design something, you already know the spacing and things that have to go with it. It has to be in a multiple of 8. If you want to use this template, then I have one set up for you. Just head over to my website. There's a link in the description below, which will then send you to a template free of charge. There's nothing in there for me. It's just a free template for you to use. So if that's something you want to use, then head over to my website to use it. It is going to be a Figma one though, so I only use Figma. So yeah, it's Figma. But you can take these principles and use it with any design software of your choosing. And that's it. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and maybe drop a comment in the comments below. I am really trying to grow this channel, so anything you do can help. I would be super, super grateful. I also offer one-on-one mentoring sessions. If that's something you're interested in, then check out the link in the description below. And last but not least, if you want to follow me over on Instagram, you can do so here. And until next time, bye!